Welcome to another football season and another edition of our Fearless Football Forecast. I'm your host, Ronnie Woodward. Tony Castlebury's with me. Jim Gentry's back. Your three favorite sports writers, right, guys?
I think that's got to be the case.
My three favorite.
Okay.
That has to be the case.
Perfect, perfect. We missed last week. The football season actually started last week. Now we have something to kind of base our picks on, our previews. So we'll start with week two, which begins this Friday. We're going to hop right into it. Tony, a huge Pitt County matchup every year. And we're talking a little bit before the show. It's getting closer and closer. D.H. Conley travels to J.H. Rose.
Yeah, like you said, the rivalry, it's actually a true rivalry, at least these last couple of seasons. After Rose had dominated for so many years, Conley has started making strides, getting better. Rose has kind of fallen back to the pack a little bit.
Yep.
Should make for a great game, particularly for the fact that Malik Gorham, a former Rampant, is now playing and playing well for Conley. Yeah. It should be a fun one.
He's definitely a player to watch in that game. Who are you going to pick in that one, Tony?
Since Gorham is playing, we were talking about it before. The kid had 3 touchdowns and 4 carries last week before getting hurt. I think that gives Conley the edge. I'm picking Conley.
All right, Jim.
I'm going to go with Conley also. I think their offense is really clicking now. One thing I do think that will be nice for Rose going into this game. Conley's going to look a lot different than Havelock. You know, when you match up speed wise,
true.
Things are going to look a little slower for Rose, but I still think Conley's going to have enough offense to win this game.
Yeah, I covered that Rose-Havelock game last week. I was super impressed by Havelock. I mean, they're so fast. So I think the talent gap is definitely more even this week. If this game was later in the year, I think I would be tempted to pick Rose, but I think Conley's better off right now. They have more players back. It's week two. Rose is still learning that offense. There's a lot of new things going on with the Rampants right now. So I'm going with Conley as well for a Conley sweep there.
I think that may be the first time that 3 people have picked Conley to beat Rose ever. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, definitely. Jim, next game, another Pitt County matchup, South Central at Farmville Central.
Yeah, both teams are coming off losses on the road last week. I think defense has got to be a concern for both. South Central gave up a lot of points at Hereford County after having beat that team a year ago.
Yeah.
Farmville, I wonder, hopefully they can take some good things away from that loss of Plymouth. They did score 20 points. I think there are some positives, but this will be an interesting matchup because someone's going to get that first win.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's going to be huge because, you know, Farmville coming off, they're good. They've lost 11 straight. This is their chance to get a win. You got South Central who, you know, you got to get a win now because their schedule's not going to get any easier.
Right.
Yeah, definitely.
It's a pretty key game, I think, for both teams.
Another thing with that is Dixon Sauls is having the moment at halftime. They're naming the field after that.
Uh-huh.
So you would think Farmville's going to have some motivation for sure, but Jim, who are you going to pick in that game?
You know, I'm going to go with South Central just because I think with it being a 3 versus 2A, I think offensively I think South Central will score enough points to win this game. I think Farmville will probably have to wait another couple weeks before they get break that losing streak.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to kind of piggyback on that point. I'm picking the Falcons as well. Farmville is kind of a legitimate 2A team when you look at school, enrollment, all that. South Central is basically a 4A school, you know, at this point, playing in a 3A conference or 3A division. So I just think the sure talent and kind of numbers alone favors the Falcons. I think it's a good game. I think Farmville will be excited, as I said earlier, because of the Sauls thing. But I'm going to give a slight edge to South Central.
Farmville Central has a dynamic player in Foskey. What do they have around him is yet to be seen. Obviously, we're only 1 week in. That kid can really play. There will be something there, like you said, the halftime ceremony. The Jaguars are going to be pumped up for that game. I don't think it's going to be enough for them to beat South Central. I think South Central gets that first win for their new coach.
All right. Tony, Aiden Griffin at Green Central is next.
Aiden Griffin has arguably been the best team we've had in the area for a while now. At least I would say the best coached. Definitely one of the best offenses. They just continue to do their thing every single year. At Green Central, though, never an easy place to play. Both teams started out with wins last week. It's always smash-mouth football between those teams. Big offensive lines going at each other, solid defenses for the most part. A really good-looking matchup.
All right, who are you going to take?
I think the Chargers are going to win. They've proven they can win on the road in the past. They're going up a division, I know that, but you know, they get a pump for that game. It's a real close game. I mean, they don't have to travel very far to get to Green Central. They're always pumped up for that thing. I think that Cornwell and the Chargers get it done.
All right, Jim.
I'm going to go with Aiden Griffin, too. They played a close game with Riverside last week. But I think if they took away some of those jitters early on where they gave the ball away early in that game, some needless penalties, that game was not as close with Riverside. So I think Aiden Griffin will win this one.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the Chargers as well. I mean, how do you pick against them right now?
Yeah.
You know, last year they finished as a runner-up in the state. I mean, they really got the thing rolling, have some players back. This game's been close for sure in recent years. So I think it's a good game. I'll give a slight edge to Aiden Griffin. Last game on our schedule here, Jim, North Pitt and South Creek in a matchup that hasn't exactly been close recently.
No. And, you know, North Pitt's probably chomping at the bit to get on the field again. They lost by a point last week they couldn't get the point after late in the game. I talked to Dave Bowl on Saturday after that, saw him out and about, and you could tell he was pretty bummed about that one because, you know, that was when they had a chance to win.
Mm-hmm.
They got a chance to win this week, and I don't think they're going to let this one slip away. They're, we're talking about a South Creek team that's struggled too, only 4 wins last year.
Yeah.
I think it's going to look like a lot of those games in the past.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So you're picking North Pitt in that one, I assume?
Yep. Yeah, okay. Definitely.
Got it. All right, I'm going North Pitt as well. Kind of as you said, I'm interested to see how they bounce back. I mean, that's a tough loss they had last week. This might be the perfect opponent, kind of the perfect recipe to kind of get rolling again. I'll go with the Panthers. What about you, Tony?
North Pitt always has those really shifty, quick running backs. They're going to be too fast for South Creek. I think that North Pitt's going to be 1-1 after Friday.
All right. Well, there's the previews of this week's games. There's our picks. Checkreflector.com this weekend. Grab the newspaper, and we'll see you again next week.